In Cleveland, they have an innovative data resource that allows community leaders to take scarce resources and focus them on the neighborhoods that have the best chance for success. This is a model that has great potential to be replicated in other communities.
I think to frame the crisis in Cleveland properly, one needs to consider 5 decades of population loss, out-migration of people, out-migration of jobs, urban sprawl. And then layer on top of that, there's the tsunami wave of foreclosures due to subprime lending and predatory lending. And this just hit the city really hard. But what's remarkable about Cleveland is that in spite of the challenges we have, this is a city of great innovation. I can't think of a single great innovation or program that we're implementing that does not somehow benefit directly from this Case Western Reserve data system, which we call Neo Can Do. The most prominent use of the data right now is with our neighborhood stabilization team.
Jeffrey Sigalski, Burton Bell Carr.
Joy Johnson, Burton Bell Carr.
I'm Joy from Burton Bell Carr. Good to see you.
Jimmy Rudick, ESOP.
My name's Jimmy. I'm with ESOP, Empowering and Strengthening Ohio's People.
Justin Fleming, Neighborhood Progress.
Frank Ford, Neighborhood Progress.
Mike Schramm, Neo Can Do at Case Western Reserve University.
April Hirsch from Neo Can Do at Case Western.
Neo Can Do is working at several levels to address the foreclosure crisis. It's working on the ground because the Neo Can Do data can zero down and zoom down to the block, to the house, to the parcel, to the target area.
And you can see immediately across the street there is an active mortgage foreclosure.
So doing a walk around to verify the condition is probably a good idea.
Do an inspection, see how that turns out.
It looks like it's in pretty good shape.
Neo Can Do has also risen above the parcel to look at the trends, the dynamics, pointing to policy issues and a bigger picture type of question as to how we can prevent such crises in the future.
So it's a partnership between those on the ground and with us who may have the 10,000 foot expertise. You roll that all together and then you really have the ability to make some change.
So I wanted to start by looking in the Lower Kinsman neighborhood. And on your map, it's Lower Kinsman number 2.
So in the neighborhood stabilization team meetings, the Neo Can Do data are presented both on a map and through the interactive NST web database.
We see here at 2887, denoted in a dark black filling as an asset. And we'll see right across the street there is an active mortgage foreclosure. So that's a destabilizing factor we want to pay most attention to because it's direct proximity to a neighborhood asset.
You want to deal with what's bad near what's good because resources are finite. We cannot intervene in every single foreclosure. But if we do something strategic, asset-based, we can start to make a difference.
Foreclosure was filed on June 9th, 2010. I'll go to the docket and find out where this is in the process.
Yeah, it looks okay. It looks good in there.
Yeah. So hopefully we can keep it that way. We'll see.
Yeah.
So you guys noted that the property is still in pretty good condition, but it's vacant. And what would be the worst case situation if we have a structure that's well maintained and goes vacant and becomes one of these blighted and vacant properties? And this is exacerbated by the fact that it's immediately adjacent to one of our assets. It's in a model block. It's been a model block for years. There's been tons of investment in this neighborhood. So this is one we really need to get on top of.
What's great about being at the NST meetings is we get to see the data in action and know what else we need to do with the data. To actually see it in action helps us get a new perspective.
Everyone pretty much agrees that to address community problems, you need deep knowledge of the community. So we wanted to have a method of getting data into the hands of people who could use the data directly.
Joy and I hit Fuller Avenue. We talked to 7 people.
Right.
One of which was Mr. Boone.
Hi, are you the homeowner?
Yes, I am.
One organization in particular that we're partnering with has a very good track record doing foreclosure prevention, that is ESOP.
We help homeowners having issues with their mortgage. Are you having any issues currently?
Unfortunately, yes. I have three mortgages.
We use the data system through NeoCanDo to identify people that are at risk of going into foreclosure.
He was interested in scheduling an appointment. He said he had three mortgages.
Yeah, I think it was becoming a burden for him, so.
I can imagine.
Yeah, he was relieved to hear about a potential solution.
Hey, good to see you.
Everybody in the nation is aware of the foreclosure crisis. Government agencies are taking it very seriously and trying to reshape themselves to avoid it. But we were starting to see this evidence many years earlier, and I think it's because we had the capacity to look at it through NeoCanDo.
We're working together more than we've ever worked before that I can think of in the city of Cleveland, and that will have benefit even after this issue is resolved.
I can't see moving anyplace else.
All right.
Not at this time.
Well, we're glad you stayed. Things are changing in the neighborhood, and we still got work to do.
They're continuing to get better.
Yes,
absolutely.